Hello, this is Hussam Hurani, and today we'll continue our lessons in text mining. And we've seen many strong functionality in Orange Data Mining, in text mining. And today we'll talk about import documents, how to import documents into Orange Data Mining, how to train and how to predict these documents. And before I start, I'm gonna use and download it already data set from Kaggle, and I minimize it a little bit so we can work on this document. So this is the data set. I'm gonna keep it in the GitHub folder for you to download also. So it is I named it mini data set text document classification. If you click on this one, you will see that we have business documents, entertainment documents, food, medical, and sport documents. If you open any of these folders, you will see that we have a certain number of documents. They are all related to business under the subfolder business, okay? So the category business, it has all the business documents. Food, it has all the food documents, as you can see, and so on and so forth. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 categories that we will work with. And as you can see, we have many documents, hundreds of documents underneath these folders. And when we use import, we will use the main folder, which is here, okay? Second thing, in the prediction, I prepared a few documents which are under predict mini data set. These are the documents that we need to predict after we train the model for the 5 categories. So we need to predict this business document. Is it business or it is something else? This is what we're gonna do in our lesson. So let's start directly, and we will go to Orange Data Mining. And from Orange, we will use widget called import documents. Import documents, okay? And from import documents, I'm gonna browse into this one here, okay, which is mini set text document classification. Okay, I'm gonna just select it. I will go back. I'm gonna just click select, and I'm gonna click select folder. Okay, so now it uploading all these documents. So we have 249 documents underneath the 5 folders, and we have 5 categories. Each folder is a category. This is what we done now. Now, what we can do also, we can view corpus viewer, okay? And from corpus viewer, you will see all these documents, okay? You can see all these 249 documents. They are business, sport, food, entertainment, etc. Okay, and per each document, you can read this business document if you want. So this is the beauty of the corpus viewer. So you can see the business, the name of the document, the path, the content. This is the content of this document. So it's related to business. And if you go down into food, for example, you will see that this is a food recipe for something. Okay, so this is what's happening in these folders. Now, what we need to do, we need to follow the same steps. We're gonna do training. So we're gonna do first pre-process text, okay? And from the pre-process text, I'm gonna just make sure that the language is English, stop words in English, and also I'm gonna choose the stop words from the folder I used to do, which is stop words. Okay, I'm just gonna make sure that it will use it, all the words that I wanna get rid from. We're gonna click apply. So now it's processing the 250 documents. Okay, and the documents are ready now to be processed. So I'm gonna use the bag of words. This is the bag of words. Okay, and in the bag of words, we're gonna make it simple. So the term frequency is the count. I'm gonna make it very very simple, but you have other options to use: document frequency, IDF or smooth IDF, etc., regularization, etc. So I'm gonna keep it as is, and I'm gonna just connect directly now to test, okay, and score. And I'm gonna use the logistic regression. Okay, and I'm gonna connect the logistic regression to test and score. It will take a little bit now to train the, yes, it's start now doing the training. Okay, and in the meanwhile, what we've done so far, we imported the documents, we viewed the corpus, we done the pre-text operations. You can of course do whatever you want in the pre-text operations. Yeah, I advise you to look into the regex. Regex inside the pre-text widget, it's very important to understand because you can control every single thing in this document. You can clean it, you can search, for example, in certain, you know, pattern in the text. You can do whatever you want with this text. So you can do many operations in the pre-text widget. So it's, I advise you to really look into this and understand every single point here, especially the regex here and regex here, the tokenization and the filtering, so you can get some accurate information about your dataset. Note that we are dealing with very simple datasets for yani, explaining what's happening with Orage Data Mining. However, maybe your dataset needs to do some very complex operations. So the Orange Data Mining support this by doing the pre-processed text. And of course, you can do your own programs on text cleaning, and you can clean your text completely, and you can bring it here directly. There is no harm for this. Still, the test and running is working because we have 250 documents. It's now 59% complete. But also we will now look into the confusion matrix. We will look into prediction, how to do prediction, how to do everything in onboard documents, because many people using Orange Data Mining also to handling documents. So this example or this lesson is very important for the people who are using documents, separate folders, etc., how to handle them, etc. So this lesson is very important. We're almost there. It's now 79% complete. I don't want to interrupt this. Now it's 89% complete. We're almost there. It will take a few seconds to complete this important operations. Okay. I'm going to just, it's complete now. The area under curve is one, which is perfect. And classification accuracy is 98%, which is excellent also. So I'm gonna connect to confusion. Let's see if there are any missing documents. This is the confusion. So we have 3 and 2 documents. They are misclassified. We can actually view them by going into Corbus Viewer. Okay, and you can double click on these 3 documents. They were supposed to be business, but it predicted them as medical. Let's just check them out. This is the one. This is the document, the first one, and this is it predicted them as medical documents. Maybe it picked up some verbs inside this, which led to the misclassified documents. So as you can see, the model, I'm very comfortable from the accuracy. We have just 5 misclassified documents, 3 and 2. But now let's do prediction. Let's do prediction. So I prepared a few documents to be predicted. So if you go here under Kaggle, you will see this folder, predict me dataset text document classification. And these are the documents we wanted to predict. Let's try to predict and see the results, okay? So from logistic, we're gonna do prediction, okay? And we're gonna connect the prediction to what? To Corbus, to import documents, okay? And from import documents, I'm gonna go into predict this. I'm gonna just select the main folder, this one, okay? It has 5 documents, select folder. So we have 5 documents to be predicted, okay? It's now working in these 5 documents. Let's see the results. So the business document, it has been predicted as business, which is good. Entertainment. Food, it has been predicted as what? Medical. Okay, so we have misclassified in the prediction. Medical to medical, sport to sport, which is excellent. I mean, in overall is excellent. So if we can just maybe see the percentages, if we click business, we will click business here. This is the 55%. Entertainment, entertainment 95%, which is very good. Let's see the medical also. The medical, it's 88%. It has, it seems that this document, maybe it has some medical related content anyway. So also, and you can try also to do some pretext operations here, and you can connect to back forwards before you do prediction. So you can connect this to prediction instead of having direct connection between import and prediction. You try it. I don't know which is the best approach. I read about it, but I did not find any satisfied information in the documentation to use this method for prediction or to use this method. Okay, but let's try to see and see what will happen if I connect back forwards to prediction. It will take a few seconds or a minute or less to see the results, but let's just wait and see if it can bring us different results or the same results. Okay, now this is the prediction, business to business, internet to food, it's the same thing. So it is the same thing. It seems that it automatically, the prediction, it convert or do some pretext formats and back forwards, maybe, I don't know. But you can directly connect this here, okay? I can remove this connection and you can directly connect this to prediction as we used, and you will have the same results. So this is the lesson for today. We done a very good exercise. We've seen how to import documents, how to deal with documents, subfolders, how to organize the whole thing, and I will leave the whole thing in the GitHub for you to download and start trying. We will also continue our lessons in text mining in the coming few lessons. There are many topics to talk about. Till then, enjoy Orange Data Mining.